I'm Rob Adams. Thanks for reading the article. I'm going to show you what we were talking about in the article about the techniques employed for video storytelling. And the first one we talked about was sequencing. As I told you in the article, the art of sequencing is just getting the same action from different angles and kind of making it interesting to the eye. So here I have my wife, Vanessa. You might know Vanessa Joy. And she's just going to be typing on this computer. And as she's doing so, I'm just going to get about four or five different shots to use in our sequence. And we'll also tie it into one of the other video techniques a little bit later on. So I'm going to start recording her, and I'm just going to ask her to start typing. And I'm getting one shot here of just her hands. I'm going to get another shot of her face sort of concentrating. This is my second angle. And then I'm going to jump over here and get a shot from behind and just kind of shoot the screen with her hands typing so she can just continue to type there. And then when I'm sequencing, I like to move around and try to work in 360 degrees around my subject. So in this case, I'm just gonna go ahead and get another angle from here of her hands. And I do see her reflection sort of in there, but nope, can't really expose it. But I'm gonna get one more shot maybe from the top here. And then it's always a good idea to get a wide shot in your sequence too, so you can kind of vary up your sequence. And I'm just gonna get a wide shot, and you can actually see the camera in the background there, but that is fine. So in a nutshell, that's what a sequence is, and I didn't stop rolling the camera the whole time I was doing that, because in the video editing program, I can simply just cut around and just take out the shots that I need. If you're a beginning video shooter, it might be a good idea to just shoot in clips individually, so you don't have to sort through longer clips later on. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna show you is A-B roll, and the idea behind A-B roll is you wanna have something to serve as the anchor of your video, in which case, in this case, I'm gonna have Vanessa talk about how she likes to type on the computer in the kitchen. Something simple like that, just getting her to say that, will become the anchor. The audio will be used as the anchor. And then the B roll, the B in A-B roll, will be the shots that we just got of her in the sequence, typing from different angles. And when we put that together on the video timeline, that's the idea behind A-B roll. So I'm just gonna have Vanessa talk, just give me like a 10 second soundbite about why she likes to work in the kitchen. So I'm using a Rode VideoMic Pro here to capture the audio. You don't ever wanna rely on the mic inside the camera. Get yourself a good external microphone if you're gonna be recording audio. So I'm just gonna focus up here on Vanessa. I'm gonna hit record. I'm gonna ask her to give me a little soundbite.
I think I am my most creative when I'm in the kitchen. So I love to do my work there. I love to type here. I love to be in a place that is bright and airy and inspiring.
And that's perfect. Now I'll use that of what she just said as my anchor or my A, and my B roll will be those sequencing shots. And you're gonna see here in a second how that comes together.
I think I am my most creative when I'm in the kitchen. So I love to do my work there. I love to type here. I love to be in a place that is bright and airy and inspiring.
One of the other techniques we talked about was reveal shots. And reveal shots can be used in a variety of different ways. Sometimes they're used to reveal a scene or an object, such as an establishing shot. Or it can be used to reveal an object in the scene or a person in the scene as well. In this case, I'm gonna use that picture frame over there as my object of focus. It's what I really want to portray in the scene or just have it come across in the scene. And the wine rack here is my foreground. And I'm using the Cinevate Atlas slider to do a camera movement, a simple camera movement past the wine rack to reveal the picture frame. Pretty simple technique, but it's really effective for bringing life to a shot with a little bit of controlled camera movement. So I'm just gonna simply slide my slider back over behind my foreground, press record, and I'm just gonna slowly slide the camera until we reveal the picture frame. And now I've already pre-focused on the picture frame, so the shot looks good. Establishing shots are used to set the scene, to tell the viewer where the next scene they're gonna watch is taking place. So basically what I'm doing here is just shooting the outside of this building. I'm gonna use some foreground, which is in this case the ground, having the camera close to the ground. Sometimes you can use an object, such as in a reveal shot, to move the camera out from behind to set the scene itself. So in this case, I'm just gonna basically start recording, move my camera just slowly across the ground here, just kind of setting the scene with a little bit of intentional movement once again, just so we can tell the viewer exactly where the scene is taking place. So the last thing we're gonna talk about is over-the-shoulder dialogue. And you see this a lot in movies when two people are on camera talking to each other, and the camera is bouncing back and forth between one shot over the shoulder of one person looking at the face of another and vice versa. So we're gonna show you how to shoot this very simple technique. It only requires two people, which we don't even have, but we're gonna use a mirror in this case. And you only really need one camera. You would just shoot the scene twice, having the actor say the same thing two times. So basically, anytime you're shooting over-the-shoulder dialogue, you always want to make sure that you're staying on one side of your subjects. So I'm either here, shooting over the shoulder of this person, looking at this person's face, or I'm shooting from this angle, over the shoulder of this person, shooting that person's face. You don't ever want to start crossing sides, because then you're going to run into continuity issues. So what I'm going to do here is just have Vanessa pretend like she's talking to somebody else. And I'm going to start recording here using this. I'm pretending this is the person's shoulder. And I'm just going to basically focus on Vanessa's face. And she can just start lip syncing now. And I'm just recording her angle of the conversation. And I would do this for her entire part, her entire scene. And then I would stop my camera, and I would move over to the other side now and do the same thing, looking over Vanessa's shoulder, but now focused on the other person's face. And she can start talking again. And this is really rudimentary, just doing it with one person in a mirror, but you sort of get the idea. That's how over-the-shoulder dialogue is done. Here's a helpful tip. If you really want to bring a viewer into the scene, into the conversation, especially if it's very dramatic or very intense or very intimate, shoot at a shallow depth of field. It's going to give you the feel of being in the scene, and everything else out in the scene is sort of being blurred out and sort of fading into the background, bringing the conversation really up close and personal.